Hello and welcome to the ITK podcast. You've got Yesh starting off.
This is Kayash
and DJJ Prime.
Well, you guys sound so excited.
Well, that was
to be here with me today.
It's an unusual intro, but we'll work.
Well, it's different.
So. It's different, yes, just like you.
Yeah, I know. Oh, thanks. Okay. Making me blush now.
Okay. Keep it moving.
Okay, so how was everyone's week?
You know how it was. Nobody gives a fuck about our week, man.
No.
I was here getting, you know, being treated like a fucking refugee and shit.
No, what makes you say
nothing
that?
Nothing wrong to refugees, you know. Just when people look down on you because you're black and shit, you know. Life of an average black man, once again. How was your week? Oh, and it was also very eventful week, Yash. We had, you know, Lindsay on the ITK, which was an amazing experience. Mm-hmm. Thank you once again to Lindsay.
Shout out to her
manager, Mr. Agu,
and her album.
Everybody else. Yeah, it was an amazing experience. We have more interviews like that coming up. Yash has been working the phones hard, and Kai is, you know, doing his own little thing in LA. So watch out for what the ITK has coming up.
Yep.
So
wait. What has happened this week? Fucking DC fucked up again with Suicide Squad. It just came out, but
did you watch it though?
I don't know, man. I'm planning to go watch it, if not tonight, like in a few days, man.
But I think it would be a good man. I think it will be a good movie.
I don't know.
Wait, what's DC?
DC is like Superman.
What the fuck is DC?
Superman, Aquaman, Wonder Woman, they're all under one.
That's probably why I don't know it.
You don't know Superman and Wonder Woman. Please shut up.
Yeah, man. Rotten Tomatoes just came out and like shitted on the movie, man. It got like 36.
The same rotten. Anyway, we've managed to wander off topic. Welcome back. Yash, DC is basically the record label that Superman, Wonder Woman, and Flash
Wait,
are under.
Do you know Marvel movies? Do you know Marvel? Do you know Spider-Man, all those fuckers?
Yeah. Yes.
This is the counterpart of that company, basically.
Oh, okay.
Arch nemesis,
so basically, guys who couldn't get into the Marvel universe, this is the other side.
I see. Interesting.
Isn't it the other way around? Didn't DC come first? DC came first.
These guys can't make a movie to save their lives. I mean, the companies that make these movies, like, they all suck compared
to
Marvel.
Suicide Squad might probably be legit. I have a feeling it's going to be a good movie. And, of course, I will watch it later on because I'm not one of those that just hypes things. But, yeah. So, yeah, Suicide Squad and Yash, I think you wanted to say, you know, some things.
Okay, did you guys hear about the recent shooting in India?
No,
please enlighten us.
I saw it on my Twitter timeline, but I don't know what
happened. Just recently. So this was, I think, if I'm not wrong, today.
Yeah, it was today.
Or yesterday.
Just now. Yeah.
Yeah, so it was apparently a rebel attack on indigenous people over land ownership. So 12 people were killed, and then you have about 15 injured. So it's actually really sad because you don't hear about it as much as you think you would about international news. So I just decided to point that out because it's like really upsetting.
I think one of the goals of the ITK is to bring you guys news from around the world that you might not hear in traditional or conventional media. Just, you know, to show you that the world is bigger than, you know,
just your average white news. No offense.
Went
out the window.
Somebody's
had to point it out. I know you guys were thinking it. I just said it. Okay.
Someone has been watching too much Hidden Colors. Kai, shut up, man.
Oh, what?
He's so lost.
It's a movie. I told you to watch it, but you guys never listen to me, so fuck off. Anyway. So Kai, what happened in Thailand? You know. Did you bang any cock or, you know?
How does one bang cock, man?
I don't know, man.
Like, Thailand is one of the strangest people for men. Like, it's actually one of the only places where if you go out, like, girls will start, like, catcalling you, dude. So it was a really surreal experience, man.
When you say girls, you mean girls or...
Legit girls, clothes. Like very aggressive girls, man.
I always imagined the place would be conservative, though. I never thought it was as liberal as it.
No,
liberal, I think
no, dude, in the like cities.
No. It's not even about that. It's really, yeah, it depends on where you are, of course. Mm. But, like, girls there are just, like, aggressive. Like, you have a lot of the really aggressive girls. You have a lot of the really timid girls. But because of our rep in town, like, town has a rep of, everybody thinks the girls are, like, good, are, like, easygoing. They're easy to get.
Mm-hmm.
But granted, those girls are, like, butt ugly. And they're, like, threes and twos. So surely anywhere in the world, mm-hmm. threes and twos are, like, easy to get. So it's like, I even sometimes go on forums and see all these fuckers like, buy a girl noodles and then like she'll bang you. Like, what the fuck, dude? Buy a girl noodles and then she'll bang you. But like, yeah, dude, like but the rep with talent is like...
Isn't it that if you're white, though, you can pretty much score anything?
No. This is a really big common misconception. And it's aided by the fact that girls think these white dudes or like these foreigners are like jacked up on money, man. Mm-hmm. When like... some foreigners that go into town, like, dude, they're poor as fuck, dude. I've just realized that there are some people who travel around the world and they're on such a tight budget. Like, dude, these guys
have... pretty much backpackers.
Yeah, those guys, basically. Yeah. Like, not shitting on them, but, like, dude, if you have to, like, travel somewhere yeah, and, like, have a fucking budget for each and yeah. every day, how much you're meant to spend, like, dude, mm-hmm. you're better off not traveling, yo.
Oh, look mm-hmm. at Mr. Agreed. Look at Mr. Arab oil money talking. Oh, if you
dude,
have,
hey,
if you have the money to spend every day.
But it's like sucks because you don't have any money, you can't spend it on anything. You're well, just going around with your backpack.
Dude, you can't experience the best. If you're going to go like that, like, dude, in my opinion, just don't travel, dude. You can't experience everything. Like, if somebody tells you, yeah. dude, let's go. The first thing you're going to be thinking mm-hmm. of is your, like, wallet? Nah, man. Let's just stay at home, folks.
Yeah.
So you said you wanted to talk about sex. Me and Yash had, like, Yash and I had, like, an interesting argument last podcast about whether or not you can tell when a girl is faking her orgasm.
I said yes. God. You can.
No, you said you can't tell.
But I mean, she already has one thing against her, though. She's never fucked a girl. I mean, to my knowledge.
What? No, but the thing is, I've done it.
No, but Yash, have you ever made a girl come, though?
What? Where are we going with this?
No, because, like...
No?
Exactly, then.
But the thing is, the question was, have you, you know, do you think a woman can actually fake an orgasm?
No, not, say, that wasn't the... No. Can you tell when a woman is faking the orgasm was the question.
Oh.
And I said, yes, you can. I said, yes, you can tell. Well, at least I can tell when a woman is faking it.
If that's the question, then my answer is no.
No.
By the end of it, like...
What do you mean no? We had the full argument there and you agreed with me at the end.
I'm still on no. Actually, I've actually changed my mind.
Change your mind how?
This is women, man. Like, one day they're saying this thing, the next day they're saying that thing. Like,
she herself knows you... certain people can tell, and I proved it to her.
No, but the thing is,
But
the thing is, having some body contraction doesn't necessarily mean you're having an orgasm.
Oh,
it doesn't. No, it doesn't work like that. You might be having a leg cramp, like who knows, or vagina cramp.
But real talk though, you know, sometimes when you have like a hamstring or like a cramp or like those muscle movements that are like involuntary.
Yeah, that's
right.
That
you feel it.
Yeah,
like girls do that when they come too. Like, how can you do that though?
She says you can fake the spaz.
No. I think what you're talking about is like tightening of the
vaginal walls.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
But yeah, you but spaz no,
those
when you come.
Spasms are like different.
You spaz like your entire like stomach section goes in, and then you start like having mini seizures. That's how, if a woman
okay,
has
that's not faking. That's definitely not faking.
Exactly. So that's how you tell if she's faking. If she doesn't do those kinds of movements, like, then she's probably not feeling it.
But this is to the guys who actually have made girls come, though.
That's
they
true.
Know the difference.
Hashtag.
So what about all those guys who've never made girls come, though?
Then I am very sorry for you.
Because I don't know about you, but, like, some guys in this world, like, don't know how to make girls come, so... Obviously, those
Amen.
Girls are going to be able to tell.
I can't relate, because, you know.
Oh, shit.
I can't relate.
Big dog talking, though.
Hashtag big dog.
No, but, like, I heard Yash talk about, like, if a guy can't make a girl come, like, she shouldn't be with him. Like, dude, do you know the amount of girls who are with dudes that can't make them come, but they make them come emotionally. Dude, I sounded corny as fuck, but...
Okay. Now, but for me personally, if he can't please me, then I'm out. Like, I can't do it. For me, it's very important, the sex. Like,
I don't know, man. Like, you girls are spoiled, man. Like, sometimes...
No,
like,
some people...
If a girl has had, like, fucking vibrators and shit that can swirl and twirl inside, like, fuck, man.
Fair
like,
enough,
dude,
yeah.
Our penis is just on one mode, dude. It's on, like, thrust in and thrust out, dude. We ain't got no vibrate, like, fucking ocean
No,
wave,
you can learn how to do those things.
Fucking
trust
turbo
me.
Tornado. What the fuck?
Tornado.
What
have you tried it?
What the fuck is a turbo tornado?
I don't know. Do you just go around it?
Basically, if you're sitting on top of a fucking washing machine while it's going full speed.
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah. Actually, I've never done that.
You probably shouldn't do that.
Yeah. Why not?
That's not a very wise idea.
Does it make it a bit tough for you?
This is one other thing, though. Like, girls can get really, like, not even get close to the thing in terms of, like, the penis, the whole penis package experience, right? But they can even go above and beyond.
You're sounding very suspect right now, man. You are going
Dude,
in depth.
No, I'm just, when you think about it, though, like, if a girl uses a fucking vibrator, like, nobody's going to call out. Everybody's going to be like, okay, that shit's normal. But if you see, like, the equivalent of that thing to guys, which is like a pocket pussy, they're going to be like, this guy's a fucking loser, yo. Yeah. What the fuck, fam? It's exactly the same shit, yo.
I know, double standards, yeah.
Because
I agree with you on that one.
Everybody is a consequence.
The question is, though, like, it's not anytime close, but, like, what would you do if a guy gave you a pocket pussy as a gift, though?
I would give it back to him and say no thanks.
What? Yash, nobody gives a shit about you. You don't have a penis, yo. I'm talking about all the guys that would like a pocket pussy instead
I
of
don't
like
fuck.
Left.
That'd be
you guys
left
are losers.
That'd be weird. Hey.
Losers.
Why would you call them a loser?
S-E-R.
Why'd you call them a loser? Why?
Because you have a pocket pussy. Go get some real pussy. If you're a real man, go get some real pussy.
Then the women who have dildos should go get some real men and throw away their dildos.
Yeah, but if we do, then
well.
You guys call us sluts.
Ooh. What? Wait.
Yeah, no, if we go around getting...
No, that's an illogical argument. We're not saying go fuck many men. We're just saying go get a man and throw away
like,
your dildos.
Get one penis.
No, but the thing is, what
yo,
if you're a man...
We just got an insight of how dirty you are, yo.
Who?
No, like, as soon as we said go get some dick, Yash said, oh, I'm gonna go get some many dicks.
No, I was just speaking exactly. For my fellow, you know, females
out
there.
You is a fuck up. But, actually...
But anyway, like, really, back to this, Yash, like, what a dildo is, like, the equivalent of that for guys is, like, a pocket pussy. So I don't see, like, how different...
Can you please not say pocket
actually,
pussy?
Actually, let me just search it up. I've never actually seen one before.
Oh God. Can we not search things up while we're recording
and,
at least?
And anyways, thing, keep going. So what would you do? Ooh, we've got a lot of designs.
Though, it's like a fucking upgrade of your left or right hand. So if you're going to do it, if you're going to please yourself, might as well go like to the top.
But would it be warm though? Or is it just like plastic?
I don't know. Go ask someone who's used a pocket pussy.
I finally researched this shit, yo. Apparently you can microwave the motherfucker.
What?
Why did you embark on this research?
Yo, prime. When I came across pocket pussy, I was like, dude.
Can you please stop saying pocket pussy?
Dude, like, I saw this shit, dude. Like, do you know Mesut Ozil? My eyes became like that motherfucker, dude. I was like staring at the fucking computer. I was like, pocket pussy. What the fuck does this
mean? It doesn't.
I went through pictures and I was like, damn, dude. They dissected the fucking pussy and put it on a pocket, yo.
Okay. I think the listeners get the idea of what a pocket pussy is. So,
yeah.
Customer service. What are some things you don't like when, like, with customer service? Like, because I know, like, there are some people when they serve you, they like to serve you like you don't know what the fuck you're doing. And they, I don't know, have you ever felt like you're talking to... Like, you're going in for customer relations, right? And you're trying to get a problem solved. And there's just this vibe that you feel like slapping the person that's serving you.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, when we talk a customer service, what is it?
No,
like,
we're not talking about sexual... Why would it concern a podcast? Jesus Christ. We're talking about, like...
I didn't say podcast, you fucking retard. I said product.
Like when you go to like a bank or to a shop, like a shopping complex, and you're like, hey, I need some help with this, and they're just like being assholes. Because to me, it happens too much, and it's like, why does this happen? I feel like slapping people.
Really? Do you experience this frequently? Because like I don't know what you're talking about, honestly.
You've never had a bad customer experience, like where the people serving you were just complete douchebags.
I mean, yeah, but like I can count them on my fingers, so it didn't like affect me that much.
Are you sure you actually interact with people?
I feel with Prime's case, it's just because you're black.
Oh God.
No, honestly, I've been around with him, and the way people talk to him, it just pisses me off. And it doesn't happen to me.
Wait, so I'm the only one.
It happens to me. It happens to me, but not that often.
And it might happen to Yash.
And I just feel like slapping that person. Like, shut the fuck up and just listen to me.
Yash. On another level, it might happen to you because you're brown too, though.
No, it doesn't, though. That's the thing.
No. I mean,
no. There is.
I would say if it did. Like, I will be honest with you. If it did, I would talk about it, but it doesn't as much.
I mean, real talk, I don't know. People just don't know where the fuck I'm from. So they just like, yeah, fuck
because it, you've got a white. Yeah, yeah. But especially with Asians, though. No offense to Asians out there.
wait, what about the Asians? Dude, I swear, man. Asians are like one of the most innocent races, man. Like, they can be racist as fuck, but people just see them as so innocent, man. When, like, in actual fact, they're not, dude. They're ruthless killers, yo.
Yeah, they are pretty innocent.
I don't know. The Asians I'm meeting make me hate.
And because maybe they get manipulated really easily. That's why they believe into the whole media and how people are portrayed. That's why I think they judge people on that basis and then just have it in their mind. And then it's hard to get out of it. So when you are in a customer service role and being an Asian, you're going to have mindsets of that particular person from that background maybe. And then just go from there with that and treat that customer like shit, you know?
Anyway, let's not dwell on race too much. I feel like I've talked quite an extensive amount.
We'll talk
about it in future. So Yash has been interacting with some Nigerians these past few,
and I'm loving it.
Hey, calm down there before I don't get too excited here. But yeah, what were your preconceptions? What were your thoughts before and after interacting with Nigerians?
Before, crazy, dangerous, very strict people. But strict? After, yeah, strict.
Strict,
African parents.
Oh, and lifestyle, then how would you attribute strict and traditional to crazy and criminal?
I don't know, it just happens to be like that.
Someone who's strict would be disciplined, he wouldn't commit crime. Can you see how stereotypes work, though? Kai, why are you quiet?
I mean, I'm just listening to this, honestly, because, like, I just wanted to go in with the fact that I thought y'all lived in huts, but, hey, I got shut down day one, so fair enough.
Anyway, continue.
No, you were saying about...
If someone is strict, or if someone was brought up in a strict environment, you would assume that person would be disciplined. Even though it can go both ways. You have people that were brought up in strict places but became douchebags. But still, you would expect that, you know, the person would be disciplined. But here you just said strict and then criminal and traditional. Someone who's traditional, again, you think would be, like, you know, more peaceful and shit. But yeah, I'm happy
But then...
Yeah, continue.
Yeah, but after it was more, wow, they're so nice and so down to earth and just willing to give you their time and just talk to you, even if it's just like one message. And it was like, wow, new people I'm meeting, it's amazing. They're actually really nice people.
She's saying this because someone entered her DM.
Not really.
Yes, really, that's all.
Two people, actually three.
What the? Wait, three?
I'll talk about it later, yeah.
What do you mean three different people?
I got in contact with three different people.
Yeah, I met in your DMs, but okay.
Yeah. But nah, they're really nice people. And I just want to get to know more of them, you know? Wink, wink.
Oh, God, this wink, wink hype, though.
So, this week has been actually quite, I'd say, interesting. A lot has happened in a weird, like, slight, I wouldn't say coincidental, I don't believe in coincidences, but yeah, we interviewed Miss Lindsay Abuday this week, which was like, I think, our first professional interview, and I think that's the direction ITK Extra will be moving. We'll be getting exclusive interviews for you guys to listen to. We'll be getting comedians, artists, politicians, activists, all kinds of people. So really do look forward to that. I know that all three of us are working hard to get those interviews. I mean, the first one with Lindsay was amazing. I wasn't even expecting it to go on for like, it was an hour. Yeah, it was about an hour, but I just like, you
dude,
know.
Dude, like I saw her Twitter. She was like the longest and most interesting interview I've done. So yeah, that was pretty right.
Wait, how did you see her Twitter when you're not on Twitter?
What do you mean? How can I see her Twitter, dude? It's not like on.
Wait, you went to stalk her? Fucking weirdo.
What do you mean fucking weirdo? You retweeted the shit, man.
Yeah, you, so you went to back to her. So you like, went thank to. Thank you.
So
like,
you went to stalk me. Why don't you just get Twitter, you fucking bitch?
Yeah, get Twitter.
I don't know, man. Guys,
I know it's a lot of effort.
Guys, no, it's not. It's literally. DM, I'm not for that life, yo.
I think then, you low-key no, like
but you
guys
get, like,
in your DMs.
Females sliding in your DMs.
No, Kai likes men being in his DMs. A man who doesn't care about that wouldn't say that.
Wait, guys, real talk. Have I told you guys that when I was in Australia, like I got offered like a PR multiple times? I mean, that was the thing. They hit me up in the DMs first, like. Yo, you're an international student. Do you want to?
You mean in physically, not in your DMs? Calm down.
No. Not physically. We'll talk in the DMs, yo. On multiple platforms.
Then why didn't you just take it?
What?
Why didn't you take the PR?
Fuck off, man. I don't know what they wanted, man. They wanted some dick sucking, yo. I ain't about that life.
Hey, you said you're willing to unhook your jaw to suck Donald Trump's dick. So why not unhook your jaw to suck some, you know, PR dick?
I said for money, dude. Yeah, I don't want fucking PR, yo.
I'm glad you just admitted on something that's going on the internet that you're willing to unhook your jaw to suck some dick for money. So Pornhub,
dude,
X-Videos.
Everybody has a price, yo. Even you.
Nah, man. I don't know. That price would have to be like...
It's all nah, man. Until
that price...
Suitcase full of money.
That price would have to be on some Illuminati shit. Like, you get to run world.
Sure.
Keep talking.
Basic ass $1
McDonald's. McDonald's.
I don't fucking know, man. What the fuck?
Yeah, your mouth be malfunctioning from all that dick you've been sucking.
Dude, I'm already unlocking that jaw, man.
Yeah, sure you are.
Sit your Indian ass down, girl. Who the fuck are you?
Oh, no, I'm seated, guys. Calm down.
Oh, learning old girl, like a fuck.
No, that was the worst Indian accent ever.
Ooh, India.
you haven't seen me do my Indian accent, yo. Do you know how many Indians are in Kuwait?
Can we bash Indians? I don't know why. I feel like bashing Indians. Hey,
right,
nobody take offense, but you know, we like to bash. I bash back black people all the time, you know. Sometimes black people do
like
stupid
bash
things.
Our friends, and yeah, it just happened that we have like an Indian here. We don't target them.
We have another Indian.
We'll see.
Our friends are mostly Indians.
Well, not mostly. We have like two. One is slightly retarded and the other is here with us.
But dude, their
personalities. Hey, who are you calling
so
slightly retarded?
Their personalities are so it's not even mesmerizing, dude. Like mesmerizing is too much. It gives them too much credit, yo. Their personalities are just so fucked up that you just have to sit back and make fun of them.
I like how they're the ones who are probably going to be listening to this. So, yeah. Hey guys.
Okay.
Retard. I'm retarded.
Oh my god, you should have seen. Oh, you're so weird, man. Prime.
Kai, did you see that shit that happened with that chick that they thought was kidnapped on YouTube? That YouTube chick from England? No?
What the fuck? I don't know, man.
What's her name?
Family, she wanted to get kidnapped, yo.
No, that YouTube thing where they thought this YouTube chick was kidnapped because her videos were weird. I don't even remember what the fuck her name was. Marina Joyce.
I don't know, man.
Just Google Marina Joyce.
Did she really get kidnapped, though?
No. I think she's on drugs or some shit, and then people just, you know, the internet happened, and yeah.
Oh God. I don't know, man. Like, the internet is a weird ass place, yo.
You know what else, like, is, you guys, weird?
No, man. Stop referencing your dick, man. Nobody wants.
Hey, my dick is not weird. It's very long and normal.
Dude, it looks like a fire hydrant, man. Come on.
Why do you know what my penis looks like? That doesn't make me feel very comfortable.
What have you guys been getting down and dirty with?
Ooh. What?
Dude, we went to the onsen, man.
Like, we never went nowhere. We didn't go there. We did not. You have never seen my penis.
Oh my God, guys. I got a new follower. This is, like, amazing.
An onsen?
Yeah, shut up.
Open bath house. So
we did not go to.
Go there to bond, yo.
I don't know why you want to bond with other guys. You are sounding more and more suspect as days go by.
Yeah, you are.
Dude, I've always had a theory, dude. Like, when you get a girlfriend, or like you're attached to a girl, the gayer you get, man, because like now you have an excuse to act as gay as you want. Because
so can we see a picture of your girlfriend?
I'm sorry, what?
You heard me.
I'm sorry. I think it's breaking up.
No, it is not breaking up. You heard me. Well, can we see a picture of your girlfriend? Hashtag where is Kai's girlfriend?
What? I can't hear you, man.
Like, you're just as bad an actor as Yash. Guys, sickening.
Oh, shut up.
Sickening.
But where is your girlfriend at, though? Let's be serious now.
I'm going to get some lemonade.
She's probably at the club getting fucked.
Yeah, doesn't sound right. Yeah,
lemonade. So anyway, in other news, the Olympics is currently ongoing. Honestly, if boxing doesn't come on, I don't give a fuck, because I like football. And
if
football
swimming doesn't come on, if running doesn't come on, if soccer doesn't come on, then I'm out, because, you know, especially the Nigerian team, though, like, wow, it's amazing.
Wait.
It's great.
Anwar, let's test it. What about the Nigerian team, huh?
It's a very strong team, you know, strong what team, it? United.
In what competitions are they strong in?
In a running, track, soccer.
Wait, I'm going to get you. Are Nigerians real good at running, or did you just take that because they're from
Africa? No, Nigerians are decent at running, though.
Oh, I see. But, dude, can anybody actually beat the Kenyans, dude? It's like those guys, like, fuck.
Kenyans and Ethiopians do long distance, not short distance.
I know, dude, like, fuck.
I know, yeah. Dude. I was so happy when we beat Japan, man. Especially after the shitty experience I had with Asians this past week. I was like, fuck you, Asians. I still love Asians, but still, fuck you.
But did you get up in that Asian pussy, though?
That's yes.
That is the question, actually.
I actually did.
Oh, really?
That awkward moment when you realize you are actually Asian, but you're retarded, so it takes you a while to realize that you're Asian. But
I'm Indian.
And India is where?
We're talking about Asians that you hate. Japanese, Chinese, etc., etc.
No. You can't just back yourself. You're from
Singapore. That's what we were talking about.
Where is Singapore in, you fucking dumb idiot?
No, but I'm Singaporean Indian.
But we'll talk, Anwar. Have you fulfilled your lifelong destiny? Lifelong destiny. Dude, like you're created for backing some type of person. But no, a lifelong dream of, like, bashing a Japanese chick.
When was that ever my lifelong dream?
Why did you go all quiet, man?
Why'd you hesitate, huh?
When was that ever my lifelong dream?
I hear that hesitation.
Kai, you can't pull the same thing just because I asked for a picture of your girlfriend.
Let's hear about your Japanese experience, then.
You started getting defensive, bringing some other shit.
I'm not being defensive. I'm just saying, you can't try and put another thing just because I asked for a picture of your girlfriend. That's not how it works, bro.
Dude, if it wasn't some real talk, like, you wouldn't bring the picture of my girlfriend up again, man. Come on, this is all about you now.
No, I know what you're doing, and you know I know that you know what you're doing, so shut the fuck up. Excuse me.
The viewers and listeners know what we're doing, though.
I know what you're doing, and, you know, I will now take a seat back, and, you know, I've never had, like, I do love Japanese people, obviously, you know, I love anime.
I mean, honestly,
speaking of anime,
we didn't get to meet some, like, hot-ass Japanese bitches, man.
And I'm very happy that I didn't, because I met an amazing person later on, so, yeah.
This plug, though, okay.
Hashtag, this is how you back out of awkward situations.
Oh, we'll talk later. Don't worry about it.
When your homeboy gets you into trouble with this.
I'm so happy you're not my wingman because you are just utter shit. Well, okay, yeah, moving.
Let's just not talk about me being a wingman.
You're the worst wingman I've ever seen. I'll never forget that one time that you were like, oh, don't worry, I got you.
You told me the story.
I have all the girls,
you know. What a massive fail.
Fucking dickhead.
Actually, share the story.
We've already done it once, man. Like,
oh. Yeah, we've done it once here. But you can share the story this time because I said it last time.
Me?
No, Kai.
Yeah, I was like, what the fuck?
Wait, what the fuck? What about you, Yash? You heard the story. Might as well, like,
well, I might twist the story, you know. So I think it's better coming from the person who actually...
I mean, just go for it because I wanna hear how fucked up Prime made me out to you.
So apparently you said, apparently you said you could get, you know, all the pussies for them, you know, to fuck that night. God. But obviously you failed miserably.
Oh, God.
Yeah, which other one?
You were all top shit and everything, but...
The rabbit debacle with you and Pedro.
Me and Pedro, dude, like, I messed Pedro up real hard, dude.
No, not that ramen debacle, the other ramen debacle that involves texting.
No, that was pretty alright, man.
No, it was not alright, Kai, it was not alright.
No, dude, like, the chick he was texting, right, low-key, the one that he, like, made all effort, like, basically what happened with this guy was, like, the girl he liked, she had a class, right? And after her class, he immediately goes in for his class. So as she was getting up, he went up to her and was like, yo, can I get your number? And she was like, oh, she was Asian, by the way. She was like, okay. So he made this whole big scene in front of her friends, right? Got her number and he was like, all right, I'm gonna hit this chick up. So after that, he added her up. I think he added her up on like a Chinese app called WeChat. So yeah. she clicks accept, of course, right? As soon as you click accept, it's like on Facebook when they send you the message like, oh, you've added a new friend, start talking to her. But it sends like it sends it in a form of like a first person. It's like me texting you. So it sent a message like, oh, we just became
like
friends.
Skype.
Let's
like
talk.
On Skype. Like on Skype with the way it's like, hi, you know, blah, 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 blah. Yeah.
So this motherfucker started like... He got all gassed up. He was like, I already got the tip in, yo. Let's go in. So he started texting her like, oh, how are you doing? Like, we were going to his place. Like the whole way there in the bus, he was like texting her and shit like that. So second day he was like, oh, can we meet up? And she was like, no, like I'm busy doing this, that, and the third. So we just wanted to like go to the city and like go eat and stuff like that. So along our way, we're walking and stuff. I saw her holding hands with some other dude and getting real cuddly with him. And then like Pedro was by my side. And because I didn't want him to see that shit, I was like, yo, Pedro, come here, man. And then I like held him by the neck or something and then like took him to see the ground or some shit. And then she passed by. But as soon as she passed by, that was all in vain, yo. Like he started seeing her and then he was like... And then like, he had the most like fucked up look in his face.
It's wait, like, why do I not know this story? This is a different... Dude, this isn't even the story that I was talking about.
No. I'm trying to save myself, yo. Let me off the leash, yo. Fuck you.
Are you changing the story? You're changing the story. I would have heard this story. There's no way this story would have happened and you wouldn't tell me.
You can bring Pedro up. I'm telling you, this is like a small detail, but like it was a fucked up thing, so I just never brought it up.
But do I know the girl and the story in general?
Yeah, it was the same girl that like he liked, you know, the
but you're adding this detail.
Yeah, I'm just adding it. This did happen though. So anyway, like it was all in vain because like she just ended up passing us by and then Pedro saw her and then like, dude, like his face, yo. It was like after your girl got the pregnancy test and it tested out positive and then you're just like, fuck. Like it was like that and then like he was depressed all the way through.
But while we're on this topic and we have a lady with us, do you think that women, when they try and not hurt your feelings, it actually does more to hurt your feelings?
What do you mean by that?
There are certain times when women will just waste your time and not tell you that they have a boyfriend, and you keep chasing them, and they'll be like, oh, I don't want to hurt these things.
It definitely depends on the person. Because if she had a good heart, she would knew that that guy had or have, you know, feelings, and you wouldn't do that to someone. But that if that person didn't give a fuck, would have been like, eh, let's just lead him on, who gives a fuck, you know? It depends on the person.
I mean, I understand where Yash is coming from. It's like when you do something and then like you don't care about the consequences. It's like when you bump into somebody and then you're like slightly rude, you don't apologize. It's the same thing. Like if a guy is after me, like I have a boyfriend, like fuck him. Like,
yeah, like, you have a boyfriend.
Yeah,
you have a boyfriend.
Fuck you, man. I'm talking from the perspective of a chick. Yeah, why do you have to hound dog? Dude, I know what you're doing. This is payback for the Japanese pussy shit. I know.
No, it's not. You're just being suspicious, man. You've just been suspicious this past, you know, that LA weather. You're
missing for
you know.
A couple of days.
Man. It's sad. I know me, man. So I'm alright.
Yeah, you know you, and he knows you as well.
That gobble laugh, fucking cunt. But yeah, what the fuck, man? What the fuck were we talking about?
But yeah, it definitely depends on the person. Like,
so what kind of person are you, Miss Kalidasan?
I choose sometimes to leave people on, but sometimes I'm like, you know what? Let's not do it.
Oh yeah, I know what type.
I've actually done it before. Honestly, I've actually done it before.
You're the type of chick that likes leading people, and it's like, oh, you like to feel.
Yeah, no, actually, I will admit to that.
Why does she have? Why does she have to moan to lead people on? Like, oh, I will lead them on.
I didn't say that.
Not you, dumbass.
Dude, the other thing is like, I don't know all these weak ass bitches, man. It's like, okay then. When they get fucking rejected, like, yo, dude. Carry on, man. Like, fuck. They
it's
get
not
all
that
depressed
easy.
And shit after they it's get not... rejected. Like, dude, she just rejected you. I mean, granted, like, off face value. Like, she doesn't fuck with how you look or how, like, she doesn't feel your vibe at all. So just fuck off, man. However, though, in the case of our friend, like, once she got to know you, like, how you text, how you talk, how you go about your daily life, and then she rejects you, like, dude, that shit is hard.
Yeah, that would be.
But honestly, women can be crazy. As much as they like to say they are not crazy, they are crazy. Every woman has a
let's be honest
degree of craziness.
What do you guys do when you get rejected? How do you guys handle it? Like, when you genuinely like that person.
That's the biggest bullshit I've ever heard. But okay,
we'll start with Kai, and then we go to Prime.
I mean, I don't know. Honestly, like
Kai doesn't get rejected. He only gets approached by men. So,
okay, fair enough.
I mean, I don't know, man. Like, I don't know. To be honest, like, I'm the type of guy who plays it safe. Like, I see the chicks interested in me, and then I just go in.
Ooh.
Is this not true, Prime?
Me? Sometimes, you know, I get a bit carried away and I think she likes me and she... No, sometimes I think that she does actually like me. But, you know, women can be complex at times and they're like, oh, no, I don't like you like that. And it's like, okay, fine. I'll just be like, fuck to you and fuck to your feelings. I just move on with life.
But Prime,
you know?
Like, real talk, like... dude, like, yeah?
Yeah, keep going.
No,
sorry.
I was just going to say, Prime, like, when you see, like, chicks are, like, checking you out and, like... You know they want to. Like, dude, it's so fun to like.
Honestly, to be honest, I don't think I've experienced that kind of situation whereby I know a chick is checking me out, like maybe in a club or something. I haven't experienced that, so I'm not gonna say I know what that feels like. Obviously, you're a more handsome guy, pause.
Oh,
but
God, this is a
yeah,
weird old story.
I said pause. But still, like, I haven't experienced that. Like, for me, it's like, you know, you meet the girl, you get to know her, and then feelings develop. Like, I'm not the highest grade of, you know, handsome dude out there. So, yeah.
It's all right, man. We're all on the come up. We're going to eat good.
But when that shmoney comes in, man, you're going to want to suck my dick, bitch.
What?
Nothing.
Let's rewind that again.
No. There is no rewind. There is only moving forward. So, moving forward into, misinterpretation. Have you ever said something and then, like, people misinterpret it completely and you're just sitting there like, what the fuck is going on?
All the time.
Like when?
Like when I lead guys on and then he gets the wrong idea and I'm like, bitch, I wasn't talking about that. Like, what?
Wait, Yash, I wanted to talk to you about this.
When
a chick has a boyfriend, right?
Yeah.
And then she tells her boyfriend, this guy is like good looking. Like, I want to get to know him. Like, what the fuck does that mean, yo?
That would mean she's trying to see if he will get jealous. So, the boyfriend.
Why would you do that in the first place?
This shit is crazy, yo.
Why would she do that?
She ends up adding him on Facebook, too?
Yeah.
She wants to see the extent of how I would. I don't care. Like, don't at me with that domestic abuse.
Yeah, no. She wants to see the extent of how jealous he will get.
Why would you do that?
And how he will react.
Why would you do that?
I don't know. Maybe he's giving her something her boyfriend can't give.
Then just go fuck him.
Or she's bored. Or she likes drama.
Dude, this shit is fucked up, yo.
And you see why sometimes people say women can be heartless. Well, then again, men do cheat. But men, crazy, when we do it, we don't tell you. No, I think the difference is when men, we cheat. Like, I don't cheat. But when men do cheat, it's like they don't tell the lady. Like, they do it low-key, you know. And most of the time, they do get caught. But it's like, you do your shit, and she doesn't need to know, nobody's hurt. But women, like, they do it deliberately. And it's like, fam, why are you doing that? Like, that would hurt. If that were me,
I mean, I get you, but like, I don't know, man. That thing was really fucked up. I didn't expect that answer from you, but dude, this thing about cheating though, how the fuck are you girls so good at catching guys, yo? It's akin to that motherly feel. You know how like even if a mom hasn't seen her son for like 5+ years, and then like they happen to meet somewhere, and then like she sees him, and then like she immediately knows this is like her son. Like, I think it's the same thing with like catching your boyfriend or your husband cheating on you, yo.
No, dude.
Because as soon as that motherfucker comes, and then like they feel some type of way.
No, dude.
The thing is, women are like programmed to like ignore these like things because they want to like make their relationship work, right? But they can almost immediately like sense something is going on.
But I don't think it's a gender specific thing or a sex specific thing. If you truly love that person, when they start changing, you will notice immediately. Once the love is there, it's because statistically, you could say on a large scale, women don't cheat nearly as much as men.
But why is that though? Why?
Yeah,
why
that's a good
because
question.
Because men are wired differently. Like our egos, like women will have sex because, you know, they want to feel the emotions, you know, they want to be connected to this person. Whereas a guy is like, that chick looks hot, I want to smash her so that I can brag and be like, I smashed her. Like our egos get in the way, and it's like, it's just a man thing, like the ego and that kind of testosterone that makes you want to have sex most times just for the, like, I did it.
Different women.
Yeah, I did it. That dominance kind of thing. And it's partly placed by society and things like that. But women, it's like they need that physical, emotional connection. That's why even with sex, you see women, when they orgasm, they behave like it's like a whole body thing. Whereas a guy is just like his penis. It's like, ugh. And then, yeah, it's over.
And another thing too, like, have you guys went up on this thing? Like, women need to be like emotionally and like mentally there for them to come, like,
yeah.
Most women, they can't just like come like men, like they just there through the process and then they're like, oh, okay, they finish the end of the destination.
It takes a while, like, to actually be. That's, I think that's the main reason why a lot of women don't actually come, because the guys actually just get done with what they're doing, and it's, you need time for us to come, pretty much. If
that's debatable. Yes, if the guy knows what he's,
yeah, that is true, though.
If the guy knows what he's doing, he can make you come in, like, 5 minutes.
Debatable. 5 minutes?
No.
Yeah, yash. Yash.
No.
Yash.
Nah.
Yash. Yash.
Nah. I'm trying to think, but nah.
Okay. There's always time to set timers.
Challenge.
Challenge accepted.
But then... challenge accepted, huh? But then this thing though, Yash, is foreplay overrated, yo?
No. Nope.
Okay, fair enough then. There we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Start going down, yo.
Yeah, nah, it's still it's good. Still do it.
But then what is the time limit for foreplay though? Because like some guys don't like
this. How are we back on sex?
Do they not? I thought they like going down and girls like.
What the? No, not
do all you like sucking sure. dick? We had this conversation.
It's like not
this
all
week.
Women like sucking dick.
I'm pretty sure, yeah, dude, like women like sucking dick, dude. It's just
that no, trust me, we don't.
Happen to not be good at it.
Oh, you don't like sucking dick now.
Dude, we're just talking here, okay? Calm the fuck down.
No, I'm calm. I'm calm. Just saying.
No, because me and my friends, we have talked and we've discussed and we know that we don't like doing that.
Oh, so you... Women would just be
hey,
like,
we're having a conversation.
Hmm?
Yeah, anyways, yeah. But no, we're not a big fan of that, to be honest.
Women will lie to save their lives. They actually do like sucking dick. Don't listen to Yash. Women like sucking dick. It's
hey,
not, don't listen to her.
What the fuck? You don't know me. Thank you very
I don't
much.
Know you, but women like sucking dick. That's no, the moral
dude,
of
I think,
the story.
I think the thing about this is like, you know their first time, like, they've never had something that like went through their like fucking throat, yo. So they might not know like and
went
once you have, like,
through the their throat. What the fuck? What do you
I
have
mean, you know,
like
man,
a?
You start like the back of the throat. And shit. Oh, God. But yeah, dude, it's like they think, oh, okay, let's go. Like I've sucked on lollipops before, I can do this. But then all of a sudden, when they get down to it, and then it starts hitting the back of their throat, they're like, fuck, yo.
I don't know how you
so
know this information.
Do you guys think this is like? Do you guys?
It's nothing like sucking a lollipop. Trust me, it's nothing like that.
No. I mean, do you guys think it's the bad initial experience that like drives them off of this like whole
yeah.
sucking thing?
Yeah. It could be. Yeah.
Man, y'all are pussies, man.
Wait, dude. Why did you group me into this?
I didn't group you. I just said y'all as in women. If you like women who get turned off by the bad first experience. Like I'll never forget. Was it Wax who talked about? He had to when he was like 8. He had to go down on women for like 30 minutes every day.
Oh, God.
What?
What the fuck? What? Dude, why was that such a specific time? Like this bitch. Like, done set up a fucking timer. Like, okay, I got the timer right here.
How do you enjoy getting head for 30 minutes?
Like, dude, I don't know, man. Like, chicks can come, like, multiple times off that shit, yo.
Really? Let's ask the lady in the room.
What was the question?
Can you at least pay attention to the fucking
No, because the line is waking up. Sorry, the Skype call. Anyways, what
you
was the question?
You don't need to tell everybody we're on a Skype call, dumb bitch. But anyway,
it was a question.
Do women can women enjoy like getting head for like 30 minutes?
Depends. If the person keeps going at it, it's gonna get painful. And
what? How would you
get
painful with a tongue?
It can get painful if you overdo it. Just like when you overdo, you can. It's just like when I'm sucking on your dick, and you know, I just keep going.
Wait, what?
Oh, I'm just so confused right now. I don't know where the fuck we're going with this.
Dude.
Oh my God.
Dude, about this thing about sucking dick and then it ends up going, dude, have you ever had a chick suck on your dick so hard the dick don't turn a different color, yo?
Okay, that's not a very nice image to have in your head.
Dude. One time a chick sucked my dick so hard,
oh,
I fall off.
Let's see, did that hurt?
It was like I had a nozzle of a fucking vacuum cleaner attached to the end of my dick. It was like she was physically trying to extract juices from the tip of my dick.
Oh my God.
He said nozzle of a vacuum cleaner.
Dude, I low-key saw my dick after that. Dude, shit was beat red, yo.
Why would you let her go on for more than like 5 minutes?
Yeah.
Dude, I don't know, man. It was that That moment when you're all shocked, man, like, fuck, dude, can you kind of harder?
What kind of shock were you in to not, like, be like, yo, let my penis dude, go?
Dude, I'll tell you what kind of shock I have. I was like, oh, okay, this is what it feels like to get your dick vacuumed off. Oh my god, dude.
It's all right. It's all right. This is a Christian podcast, so let's talk about Jesus. Let's remove this, these simple topics away from us. So, yes. Oh, do you know Jesus? There was this huge uproar on Nigerian Twitter. So a pastor came out and said, "If a woman can't, a man shouldn't marry women who can't cook and clean." And I think he said women shouldn't marry men who don't have jobs or something like that. Do you guys agree?
I mean, real talk. I'm from the Middle East, so I wholly agree with this dude, yo.
Because real talk.
Like, I don't know how it is for you guys, but like in the Middle East, it's like.
What do you mean you don't know what it is for you guys? What do you mean? What do you mean?
No, dude. I'm talking about in general. Like, people might not know, like, how people do it.
Oh, right. Sure, bitch.
Yeah.
But basically how it is like, a woman, her main role basically after marriage is just, like, to have kids and provide the meals for the kid and the husband when he returns from work, right?
Oh, God. Mm-hmm.
So I think, in my opinion, if, like, a woman doesn't know how to cook, then that's, like, a huge debacle because then you'd have to bring in people who know how to cook or, like... So, yeah, like, if she doesn't know how to cook off the bat, like, it's a really huge obstacle, no matter how...
So, would you marry a woman who doesn't have... Who doesn't know how to cook?
No, dude, if I really like the girl, then fuck it, man. I'm a cash out, and then I'm gonna send her to a fucking cooking school or something, dude. End of the day, she has to know how to cook.
I think a woman does need to know how to cook, to be honest. I'm not gonna sit here and be like, I'm the most progressive dude and be like, nah, you know. Women, you should know how to cook. Even a man should know how to cook. Everybody should know how to cook. But I don't know. I kind of would like to come home and my wife has food, like, prepared for me.
Dude, it's just a nice feeling, man. And especially if she's not working, like, if you come home and she's not working, like, I don't know if I'm sounding like a dickhead, but, like, yo, at least, like, you should have cooked for me. I was, like, out there, like, hustling all day.
Yes, and then, you know, we can have amazing sex afterwards.
Yeah, and then, like, we can eat your pussy for dinner or something like that, I mean.
I don't think she wants, like, you know, that, you know. What Arabian food? I was about to say curry-scented, you know, breath on her vagina.
Wait, what?
So, Yash, no, what, man, do you...
It probably smells like kebab or some shit.
Okay, fair enough. Yash, what do you think about this? Are we...
I think it should be a mix. So I think the women should work. I think the men should work. I think the women should cook. And I think the men should cook too. Because if you get a woman doing it 5 times a week, every single day, and not work, she can get depressed. And if a man, you know, goes out working every single day, he can get depressed from just working that lifestyle. So I think a mix is actually good because it keeps it balanced.
But if you're both working, what happens to the kids?
Exactly.
No, because one person's going to be, I guess, they might have to balance it out part-time, full-time, whatever it is, you know, work out that work schedule and then, you know, help the kids.
Work out
the... So it depends on what you're doing also. Like, if you're a manager, you're not going to be, you know, you're going to be busy, so you're going to be at work.
So how would you take care of the kids? Who takes care of the kids? Because I think that's the main reason why we have...
I would make time for my kids. I would definitely put my kids first and also take my work seriously, obviously, put that first too.
But it's easy
there will always be time. There will always be time to make time for your kids.
It's easy to say that when you're in this now that you don't have a very demanding job. But I think that's probably the reason why we see people behave the way they behave these days. It's like
families. I think sometimes also it's a give and take. So if it's work, you might have to give up on some things at work and, you know, sacrifice some of that for your family time. And if it's family, you might have to sacrifice some of that time for work, you know?
But
you
can't
have the best
of
both worlds.
I mean, that's true. Like, I know the argument you're trying to make, like, people can always make time. But mind you, like, most people work, like, 9-to-5 jobs, right?
Yeah.
5 days in a week, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, you have kids, right? Let's say you have one and then you go on to have two. 9 to 5, 5 days a week. So when you get home, like, you're tired as fuck. So who does the cooking? Who does the... Like, I don't know. Like, it just doesn't work like that, does it? Like, Okay, let's say you and your husband, you guys work, right? So,
yeah.
Like, the way you're suggesting is, like, you go this day, I go that day. But most jobs don't work like this. A full-time job is, like, you know.
Mm. Yeah, yeah, that's true. Full-time. Yeah.
That's so why I just want to be, like, in a position where I'm rich and I don't have to work as much.
Under someone, yeah.
And she doesn't even work at all. Like, I do not want my wife working. Like, I make more than enough for us. There is no fucking need for us to work. Let's sit down, you know, build on bigger things and take care of our families.
What if your wife becomes fat because she's not working as much?
How do you,
and that, she stays at home.
What do you mean?
I mean, she's sitting at home, yo. She can go to a gym.
Nah, that's not a logical argument, Yash. Come on.
Why Dude, would you, this is one thing I want
to... You go to the gym.
Because I think,
what if she
I
becomes think, lazy? What if she becomes
how would she
not
become
motivated
lazy?
With her life?
I don't, I'm not attracted to lazy women. Please.
No, guys, but what if she becomes?
Why do y'all women like get fat after 5 years after marriage, yo? Like, I understand like kids and stuff, but why the fuck, like, you guys weigh like 45-50 kgs by the end of the fucking 50 year, you guys are like 70 kilograms. Like, what the fuck happened, yo?
It happens with guys too, not just girls.
True.
I mean, okay, this is, I just wanted to say, like, yo, it's guys. that's fucked up. But I mean, I don't know, man. But
I think,
like,
we just get comfortable.
Because you get lazy, you don't feel the need. Like, maybe in certain relationships, they're like not pushing each other. But others, they're like, let's go to the gym. Let's push each other to be better. So I think it depends on the relationship and the individuals involved.
But dude, second thing, like, I always thought about this and like thought how messed up it is. Like, dude, like, when a man is, like, going out to work and then the woman is just, like, sitting home, like, taking care of the family, right? Like, dude, the man is, like, holding all the chips, man. Like, the woman in this situation has absolutely no power over the whole marriage.
And that's what I would hate
to
be in.
This is why a lot of women, like, want to go into the work. No, no, I think what point you're going to bring. It brings the whole, like, trust and thing issue, right?
The whole what?
The whole trust issue, like, you just have to trust that, like, yo, I'm just, like, going out there making money. This money is, like, for the both of us, so you don't even have to, like, trip on anything.
There's a reason why people don't face those situations is because they get, when, before they get married, they don't understand the person that they are getting married to. And you can attribute that to the fact that people don't communicate. Before, even though I'm bare young, when I'm getting into something, I'm like, this is what I want from this. Do you want this? No? Goodbye. Yes? Okay. We agree. We communicate and we know what we each want and what each person is bringing. You say that from the beginning and you save yourself the stress of 20 years down the line. You're like, oh, I didn't know this.
Yeah, I think people just don't talk.
People don't talk and they don't take the time out to understand the person they're with.
They just go through that honeymoon period at the start of the relationship. And when it gets hard, I think they just leave because they don't want to sit down and talk.
And it baffles me how people end relationships just because it got a little bit tough. Relationships are meant to be tough. You're meant to have good and you're meant to have bad. But when you go through that good, and that's why whenever I get into the argument, I'm like, yo, there will be days when we will argue, we will fight. But you need to understand that it's normal and we're just... We're different. We still have our differences, but we need to be able to fight and get through those differences and move forward. So I think, it's probably because people don't understand the person they're with and they don't take that time to understand the person.
And also, I think with women, I think they want to have some sort of independence. They don't want to fully be relying on someone because, again, as Kai said, because of the trust issue there, like, it would be very hard for someone to fully trust that person and rely on him because you're leaving your family for him.
If you really,
that's true.
If you really know and love that person, you will not think about reliance because people rely on each other. You might not rely on the person for financial support, but you might rely on that person for emotional support, for mental support. For physical support.
Yeah, that's true too.
They're different things. And people overlook that. Just because a man is making bare money doesn't mean that the woman isn't supporting him in a way that he can't support himself.
Of course.
Because I grew up seeing that, you know, dad would go out to make the money and when shit was tough, it was mom that was like really holding it down. That was what I saw. So for me growing up, I always knew that even if I'm not the one making money. I can support her in another way. Of course, that's not likely to happen purely because I grew up African. It's like, you are the man. You have to go out. You have to work. The woman can take care of you. If she wants, she can work for herself. If she wants, she can stay at home. I'd prefer for her to chill because I don't want my woman going through that stress. But that's a different topic. So, yeah. Get to know the person you're with before you get with them.
Yeah, that's true. Kind of fucked up we still have like arranged marriages. I mean, Yash would understand what I'm talking about, bro.
Totally. Shade,
dude, don't they have arranged marriages in the Middle East?
Arranged marriages in the fucking...
Actually, Kai.
In
Kai.
India is crazy, dude.
Even child marriage.
Kai.
What up?
Kai. So yeah, you've said in Arabia, instead of you having vaginal sex, people do anal.
Oh. Is that true?
Dude, it's because like... Obviously, when y'all have to come from the perspective that all these motherfuckers are like horny as fuck, right? The dudes and the chicks. Mm. So when they get together and they want to fuck, obviously the chick has a big obstacle because, like, okay, in the near future she gets married and then like
a big obstacle.
When the guy rams her and then like she doesn't bleed,
rams her.
Obviously it means she's not a virgin, and then like this is a huge issue in our religion. It's like fuck, man, she got fucked before, so. This is not what we signed up for. So, to protect, like, her future, she takes it up the ass, basically. Dude, this is what we... Hashtag, like, this is what we're gonna name the fucking episode, man.
What?
Take it up the ass to save your future.
Oh, God, no. We were going to rename it The Fucking Idiot Returns. So, you guys do anal?
Yeah.
That awkward moment when you told me it was haram to do anal and I believed you and you used it in an argument once and it wasn't true.
No. It's legit true, dude.
It's not true. I googled it. No. Sorry. It's haram to do anal, but it's not haram to do oral.
Oh, no. What?
But you told me both were haram and I was like confident. I was like, no, it is haram. And then the person was like, fam, no, it's not. Fucking dickhead.
Wait. You mean somebody like... Rebuttaled you. Dude, you fucked up, man. It is haram, you.
No, it's not. I googled it. Oral is not haram. You can please each other with your mouths.
Anyway, dude, low key, send me the link after this and then I'll go to this mufti and then I'll fuck him up. But anyway, yeah.
Wait, why you want to fuck up the mufti, man? Those of you who don't know, a mufti is like an Islamic scholar, basically, yeah?
Basically, yeah, somebody who explains the Quran, yeah.
Yeah.
But, I mean, this is the thing, though. You gotta know that, like, they've got some... Dude, they've got places where you can pay the mufti, and then, like, he basically... Basically, they pull, like, a Jesus, and then, like, he exempts you from your sins and shit like that.
That's the biggest load of horse... That's the biggest load of horse bullshit I've ever heard in my life, man.
Dude, you don't know, man. These places, like, you go pay a mufti, and then, like, he comes out and says, like, oh, okay, you can do this shit.
This is the whole problem I have with religion. Some dude has an epiphany and then feels like he is better suited to tell people what to do.
I totally agree with you, and then you just read the Quran and then everything's up to interpretation, man. Why do you go to all these fuckers?
Exactly, that's what I don't is? Even with religion in general, why are you believing someone else's philosophy? Why not apply and understand the world yourself and then apply your own philosophy? Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha, may God forgive me if they are legit, but they just applied philosophy and their own understanding of the world, and people just take it as though those people are some higher beings. They are not higher beings, because then you would contradict the various religious texts that you are quoting, because they are human. But you're saying, no, they're higher than me, therefore I need to follow what they were saying. All these things are outdated, and even going to muftis or in West Africa, as we call them, marabu, like going to them for them to pray for you. Can't you pray for yourself?
What the fuck? They're praying for you?
Yeah. They pray for you. They give you blessings. You do sacrifices. There's one you just said, like, they wipe your sins. How is a human able to wipe your sin?
Dude, no, but like, I'm telling you, you fucking basically, like, I don't know, man. It's messed up. You basically pay them And then they're like, why? They say this is allowed to you.
You pay someone and they... Can people please see how retarded that sounds? I am paying...
It is pretty retarded.
Dude, it is pretty retarded, but like, I'm telling you, this shit is illegal. Like, it's not meant to go down. People generally go to muftis to find like... To find like enlightenment. Like, they want to know what this like whole text means. And then they explain the shit to them.
I don't know why... Yeah, continue.
No, like, a lot of shit happened. Like, should I really go into the tobacco incident in Kuwait?
Go into it.
Anyway, like, back then in Kuwait, like, the whole... fuck, dude, I can't even remember the whole story. But basically, like, a huge product that they were selling back in the days was, like, tobacco, right? Everybody back in the days used to smoke tobacco. Mind you, this is because, like, they still haven't come out with the cancer research and the fact that tobacco and smoking was the main factor of getting cancer. So everybody started buying tobacco, like, even and then they started jacking up the prices. People still bought them and stuff. But then somebody actually came out and said, like, it was forbidden to smoke because it destroys your body from the inside, and you're not meant to destroy a body that was gifted to you, because it's not, it doesn't belong to you. But people like gave money to these like scholars or religious scholars, and then they came up with like another lie saying like, oh, this doesn't destroy your body, it's all right to smoke it. And then like this basically like, yeah, people started buying it, and then like the whole tobacco industry started gaining more money. And yeah, that's pretty much it.
I think it's just from greed that people actually did that or started that just to make some extra money.
Yeah. But like, yeah, like because people are like lost in this world. So just because when somebody comes out and then like tells them they can do certain things, like people just run off with it.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. All I know is that all religions now, when you actually go and study, they all come from one another. Quite literally.
I don't know. Like you're doing your own thing. But like for me, honestly, it just makes me feel good that I'm like following something. Honestly. But
why do you have to follow something that was laid down a long time ago when you know what is morally right or wrong?
No, I know what is morally right or wrong, but like it's not like I'm following this religion blindly. Like if this religion told me to like kill somebody or like do something that was against my will, I won't do it.
Then but then yeah, you're not, but then religion is total submission. So if
submission
someone
which way?
Uh-huh. No, Islam is total submission. For example, let's use the example of Islam. Islam is the total submission to the will of Allah, correct?
Yeah.
So if they were to tell you that it is the will of Allah for you to kill someone, you would, if you really believed in that religion, you would do it.
Yeah, but then that would be against me, and then I wouldn't follow it, though. You're just like making extremes that were there
These are extremes that are realities. There are people telling people, yo, God wants you to kill these people, go and kill them.
No
yes,
come on, dude. You know better.
I know yes, obviously there are places where it is, you know, not like that, but there are also situations we have to accept the facts. There are situations where it is just literally people saying go and kill these people because God wants you to. And they are willing to go and kill these people.
No. I know the effect of religion on people who are deluded. But like, my main thing is, like, the religions, like, specific religions don't actually tell people to do this. It's just because people are willing to listen to instructions. And those guys handing out the instructions tell them this. So basically, they're using religion for their own means.
I don't know what it is. We could go back and forth on the various things within religions that aren't exactly, you would say, good for us. But I think we'll leave that for another, you know, episode.
Yeah, all right.
Moving on. Yeah, she's very quiet now. Are you sleepy?
I don't know, no. Man. I think all this like went to her head, man. She was like, "What the fuck, yo?"
Well, what did you think of the conversation? You didn't say much there, actually.
Because religion is always like a tricky topic.
I don't mind.
I can see her point of view, and I can see yours.
I want the conversation. I like those conversations. I don't believe we should be scared to talk about them. You shouldn't be scared to talk about anything. talk about it.
Calm the fuck down.
No. It's not. I'm calm. I'm bare calm. But it's like, the more you talk, the more you learn.
I understand Kai's point of view because I also follow a religion, but I don't follow everything they say. Like, you know, don't have sex before marriage. Like, those things, it's like, you can't help it. It's just human nature. But I also believe in, like, carrying out, like, spiritual things to actually connect on that spiritual level.
Then why are you picking and choosing? Why not just do what you want to do instead of saying you follow something, but you don't really follow it? Because if you're following something, you would go through with everything. But now you're selecting, so you can't really say you are that
thing. I'm not fully religious, nor am I not religious at all. I'm somewhere in the middle. That's what I would say. I would consider myself somewhere in the middle. I'm not fully religious, and I don't follow that religion religiously. I do it parts of it. But that doesn't actually say, you know, if you don't follow everything, you're not, you know, religious or anything like that. It doesn't say that.
You're not part of this religion. It's like, I mean, end of the day, we're not like perfect beings, are we? So, I mean, like, a person who is able to follow this would technically be considered like somewhat like a perfect being. But I don't know, man. Religion is just like, to be honest, the way I've seen it, is just like generally good guidelines. And then, when you follow this, things actually make sense, man. Because no, real talk, like, let's think about it. Like, people bring this point up a lot about, like, sex before marriage, right? Granted, I mean, like, how many children do we have, like, without parents and all that shit? I'm not making argument for the fact that, oh, if these people were, like, married, these kids wouldn't be, like, homeless and shit. But you can't bring it up to me and say, like, oh, if all these people didn't, like, start fucking and having children before marriage, like, this shit wouldn't have gone south like that, yo.
But why is marriage a determinant for when you should have children? Marriage, we've seen so many marriages fail. So why is marriage the determinant? You've seen marriages fail and then the child is essentially left stranded. Marriage is an institution that was created like long after. The first humans were created, they said, "Oh, we are going to get married." Like, that wasn't how it happened. This was created.
I'm not making an argument for any of that. I'm just saying, what's the main purpose of sex, though?
The main purpose of sex is to procreate. Animals don't get married before they procreate. They just procreate. So you shouldn't say don't have sex before marriage because you don't want to have children.
No, but
the common sense.
The amount of animals aren't there, though. Like, you can't equate them together.
There would be if we didn't fuck up the world. What did religion do to us to prevent us from fucking up the world?
Well, I mean, this is not a perfect world. We can't do everything.
If it was a perfect
I'm just
world, I think.
No, you guys don't get the point I'm raising. The point I'm raising is we don't need religion to tell us what to do. These things are inherently built into us.
Okay, what would the we whole do without concept religion of, then?
What do you mean, what would we do without religion?
But, if we didn't have Anwar, religion...
Like, No. Anwar, but us as humans, aren't we just like following people? Like, can you honestly say you yourself, you're not following anybody at all?
I never said that. However, I gain inspiration from things, but I don't follow something in its totality. I do not claim I am a follower of a person. Why? Because there are things that you don't agree with that person. And I don't believe in implementing the philosophy, the entire philosophy of a person as a blueprint for my life. Because I know my life and his life would be completely different. So why would I follow the blueprint of his life? And secondly, why would I follow one religion over another religion when they're saying essentially the same things?
But basically, isn't the whole purpose of like following a religion, it's like you're following a being that's higher than yourself?
What you can follow a being, you can believe in the existence of a being without following a particular teaching. These teachings are essentially the same. If you look at...
But like those... I don't know, but like those, these teachings are like basically things like derived from that being, right? It's like that being instructing us to do these certain things.
Do you really think that being would tell different people different things, or would just give us one message in general? If that being was really giving us his message, why would he give it to different people? Why wouldn't he just tell everybody, yo, let's do this? Why would it give it to these people at one period of time? And then at another period of time, he say, you know what? These people have been fucking up for so long. Why don't I give them that message again? But I'll change it a little bit and give it to them in their language. Why not just give it to them at all the same times?
Because time changed, does it not?
Time does change, but the guidelines of the universe don't.
No. The thing is, like, okay, let's say for at this certain time, right, I come up with something and then I pass it down. However, as time goes through, because these, mind you, are not perfect beings, right? And then there's things that's told in the scripture, they don't follow it. So they're going on another path. And then he has to, like, come down and then give another whole teaching. Is that not it?
But why would he give different, why would he tweak his teaching? Wouldn't his teaching be the same throughout time? And why wouldn't he give it to all the peoples instead of giving it to selective groups?
Because times have changed. Because, like, if the intended sculpture has succeeded, which it clearly did not the first time, and people have derived from the way he wanted them to go, so he had to pass down another one. I don't know, Yash.
I don't know. We'll discuss this.
And the thing is, I don't know, man. I think people generally don't want to think that, because the main thing people generally like, I mean, I won't say they like to think of, but it's always in the back of their mind, why was I born in the first place?
I've actually never thought about that. But it shows that you're lazy. That's the problem I have. It shows that you're lazy. You would rather believe what someone else tells you the guiding principle of the world is. But the thing is,
if every single person did the same thing you're doing now, where would this world be?
We would be thinking on a higher level. No, we wouldn't. We'd be thinking on a higher level. We'd challenge each other's thoughts instead of blindly following things.
But challenges lead to conflict, and conflict can lead to war.
No, if we were a highly...
Dude, that sounds like an answer that you read throughout and then you memorized it multiple times for like an
not
essay
really.
Or some shit, yo.
Who?
No, Yash. ideas lead to conflicts and conflicts lead to war.
That just came like that, so you know.
It is easy to have misunderstandings. It is easy to have dialogues. The reason why people have conflict is because they're immature. They're immature in the way they handle things. You look at most of the conflicts of the world, it was an immaturity. The main reason why you fight someone is because you're not mature enough to handle it in the proper way, to have a dialogue and to understand. Mm-hmm. That's why you see people shy away from things that they're uncomfortable with. And then when it gets too much, they don't know how else to react but to shut you up. But if we were really working on the level of a higher intellect, of a being that we want to ascend to that being, the Almighty, but we don't want to think for ourselves. But all these people that we're following, they thought for themselves. Buddha attained a state of statelessness because of...
What about Hinduism?
Hinduism.
Do you know much about it?
I know little here and there, but you should be more educated on that, seeing as you do practice Hinduism.
I don't know, man. Honestly, the only thing I know about Hinduism is, like, y'all don't eat cows, and then, like, y'all have, like, many gods, man.
That's the thing. That's why you don't... Yeah, that's what confuses me, because you have so many gods, and then you don't have a person. You have just gods who are not... You can't... It's not human. It's God in a different way.
I've seen multiple of them. There are some in town too. Like there's one like that looks like a woman, and she has like many hands. You know.
Yeah, that's the god I was telling Anwar about.
Okay, shit. And then there's also like an elephant with many faces.
Yes. So that's the elephant god. Yeah, Ganesha.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
Oh damn.
Everybody knows this too.
He's a lucky god. He's the wealth god.
God. I see. That's why people pray to
always,
this dude,
yeah.
Man. Like, dude, like people
like good luck and nights. Yeah, that's why so there's so many different gods. It's hard.
But dude,
every single one, yeah.
Yeah, that is true.
People are scared to think for themselves. And I
But how understand do you explain why
there is a, I wholeheartedly give you that. Yeah.
And I understand that. There's comfort with being with the group. There's comfort in knowing that every, you know, oh, he thinks like me. I must be right. But I think that's lazy. I think you should go get the information and form your own thought. Experience things and think for yourself, what is this world? Because to me, honestly, I don't think God is sitting there listening to us pray to him and being like, oh, he's prayed to me today. Oh, okay, I'll do this for him. I don't think he's like that. Because then how would you explain people who don't believe? Because if we're to be very frank, and I'm sorry to say this, the most religious people aren't the richest. And the richest people aren't the most religious.
No, I know what you're getting.
And don't bring this whole, you know, they will be rich in the hereafter. You cannot starve. Okay. No, I'm not saying you personally. I mean people, their rebuttal is like, you'll be rich in the hereafter.
Yeah.
How do you know? The whole process of being a human is that we don't know.
No, we don't know, yeah. But like one thing though, one thing that I can't get through my mind, like this is the thing that I keep going back to, and then I'm like, okay, like I honestly like.
Don't get me wrong. I believe there's a creator. Definitely. I know that.
Yeah.
I'm getting to the point where I can say I know there's a creator. I know there's a system.
Hereafter, though? Like, do you believe in heaven and hell?
This is the thing I don't even know. I feel like there's something after. I do feel like there is, but I don't know. Nobody knows. We believe or we feel or whatever, but we don't know.
Just finish your point.
What we have is what is here before us, and you should be able to experience and learn and form your own thought process instead of just flocking that groupthink thing. Religion is groupthink.
Of course, yeah.
Yeah.
But like one thing that I keep going back to, and then like when I start thinking about it, really like makes me feel some type of way, right? It's like, okay, all these guys, like all these like criminals, we know, let's not talk bullshit. We know that people who make shit tons of money, like they make dirty money, like they go through like, they fuck people over, like they do underhanded shit, all that, right? And don't get me to the fact that where people steal other people's life by either killing them or blackmailing them or whatever. Like, who's there to, like, really enforce it? Like, how do these people get punished or anything like that? Like, what do you think about this?
I think it's a system. And I was talking, I think I told you as well, the way you have, like, a video game and you might complete a level and you go to a different level, hashtag on a new level. I think life is like a game. I think God was like, you know, a developer, maybe, if we to, you know, give an analogy,
if we talk about it that way.
So each, that's why I believe in the principle of karma. It's not literally that God is sitting there doing these things to you. It's that it's inbuilt in the universe, in the world. You see, when you have a proton, it attaches to a neutron. The positive attracts the negative. Or when you like Newton's principle, action and reaction are equal and opposite. Whatever you do, you will get something back. So I think those principles define the earth. I don't think it's literally God sitting there and being like, okay, you fuck this person over. Okay, I'm going to get you, but not today. You can go today. I know when I'm going to get you. I think it's something built into the universe. Whatever decisions you make now has a rippling effect throughout the universe, even on a subatomic level, and it will eventually come back to you. That's what I think. I think God, the creator, whatever, built in that system. So whether or not you pray to him directly, but what your actions is what will determine how you live your life and possibly the hereafter.
Mm-hmm. No, that definitely is the main point, like how you treat people and how you go about your
day. Yeah, that's how I feel. And I don't feel you need a religion or some dude to tell you that. If it should come, it's instinct. The same way animals have their instinct, you have instinct as well. Because when you slap somebody, you know, fam, I slapped someone. You don't need, you like your conscience. We call it, you say your conscience. When you steal something, you know it's bad. Even atheists, when they steal, they know it's bad. It's that, it's within us. So you don't need some power, like some dude coming and being like, yo.
No. Yeah. No. Actually, that's not it, though. When we steal something, we're not afraid of some other being, or like, as you would call it, karma coming after it, because we know for a fact if we get caught, we're gonna like have issues here and now. Not talk about
that. That's now, but back then people wouldn't steal because they'd say, oh, if you steal, God would punish you. Or if you were in the Middle East, if you steal, you get stoned to death. Those were the principles, and then from that became law. Mm-hmm. That was, and some societies didn't even have religion, to, like hereafter and hell and God. They just enforced these laws.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know. I'm probably wrong. Maybe, you know, religion is right. Maybe there is one religion. But for me, I believe, like, I read on all of them. I don't believe in, like, you should just be born a Muslim and not open up your mind. Read on all of them. And form your own understanding of the world. Don't be lazy. Don't just follow things. Learn and understand and think for yourself instead of just following the flock.
Of course.
Mm-hmm. If you're to take away anything from this episode, if you're still listening at this point, don't feel the need to groupthink. Be open to being an individual. Be open to thinking for yourself.
Think for yourself.
I don't know, man. To be honest, like, I talk all this, like, big talk and, like, following religion, all that other stuff. But, I mean, end of the day, I know, like, I've been programmed, like, from birth, like, interactions with friends. Like, that's everything that, like, set me down now, man.
You know, the irony of it is it was actually something you said that triggered me. Well, not really triggered. I'd been thinking. But one thing you said was, like, damn, he's right. Because you see Muslims, they're like, they smoke, they drink, they fuck. But pork, they'll be like,
eat pork.
Yeah, and it's like, why? Why do you select which sin not to do? I thought all sins were like equal. And then they'll tell you, you can do whatever sin you want to, but you just go do this one thing and it's a clean slate for you. Why?
I mean, no, that's low-key a joke, but yeah, I know what you're saying.
No, Hajj is not a joke, dude.
No, they tell you. Clean slate.
No, they tell you God washes away your sins, even if it's as plentiful as the foam in the sea.
You know what I do?
What do you do?
Well, like when I have sex, oh, right? What God. I do pretty much, like, you know how you're not allowed to do it before marriage, etc. I just accept the fact that I've done it and it's human nature, and I just carry on with my religion. I don't go and give offerings and be like, oh, please forgive me for doing this. I'm just like, you know what, I've done it. Yeah. If you're going to punish me, sure. But I'll take it. But if it's not, we'll go on. Like, you know, it's not like I'm going to give you something to, you know, not punish me. I don't do that. That's what you were talking about, Prime, about, you know, giving offerings and, you know, saying, oh, it's a clean start now for you. I don't have that thinking. I don't know why people do, though. I think
because they feel guilty, I guess.
I don't feel guilty. I take it 100 that I took that decision to actually go out there and do it. And if I'm doing it, I don't want someone else to, or even God, to actually, you know, punish me. If God's going to punish me, sure. But no, I don't do the offering thing. I don't believe in that.
I mean, in Hinduism, is there an offering for, like, when you fuck up, though?
Yeah, there is, definitely. So many.
Oh, there is? Real talk. Shit.
Yeah, you have so many, you know, offerings, what you can do, give milk, you know, buy flowers, etc. You know, go to the temple, light up the
lantern.
No, the incense sticks. Incense sticks. You know, pray, sit in the temple, read the... you know, the Sanskrit?
The sculptures,
read
that. Yeah.
There's a lot you can do. A lot of people do that. Even in, Hinduism, a lot of people do that for forgiveness. But it's, for me, it's like, no. Like, you know.
All right.
You made us that way, so why, you know, it's, yeah, that's just what I think.
I don't think that the creator would create us to have these things. Mm-hmm,
to do these things, yeah, that's, yeah.
And then be like, oh, you're doing it. You shouldn't do it, fam. No, it's not like that.
There's a point why everything is created anyway, so, yeah.
But yeah, I'm not saying go out and start murdering people because there is no God. Obviously, you shouldn't do that. I do think, but whatever you do will come back to you. So always be a good person so that good energy follows you. I believe in energy, man. Energy is is a legitimate thing.
It's a legitimate thing. I don't know, man. I still, honestly, I don't believe, I low-key believe in karma, but karma after what, though? Like, if somebody's dead, like, what can you do to save him, though? That's the thing, though. Like, let's say you, right? You are like, you have all this aspiration of like changing the world, whatever. One day somebody pulls up a gun, shoots you. Now what's your karma? Like,
You don't know what's happening afterwards.
Exactly, but like, but for you, in the here and now, like, you're dead. That's it. End of story. Finito.
But you don't know what happened before I died. Like, you look at it like this. Malcolm X, for example, or Martin Luther King, they died, But their history lived on forever.
No. I understand.
So you could say, but you could say, in them dying, they achieved immortality.
I know. But we're talking about like world-renowned figures before they were assassinated, right? Okay, let's take it to beginning even. Let's say somebody who's like 1 year old, and then like for some reason he lost his life due to some other being interrupting his like direction in life. And then what's his karma? Like, what's his?
But here's the thing. We don't know what happens after you die. You could be reborn and be the motherfucker, or you could go to some other place, maybe heaven. You don't know.
But that's the thing, though. This is why, like, people follow religion, I think, because, like, it gives them the sense that, like, after you're dead...
Sense of security, like, I guess.
There's continuity. Because, like, dude, people would, like, flip the shit if they're like, oh, okay, I die, and then that's just it.
Then just live your life. Live your life like you are going to die and nothing is going to happen afterwards. That's why I admire atheists, because they live their... They're like, I will live my life because if I die tomorrow or the person dies tomorrow, that's it. You don't get a second shot. So live it like this is your last shot.
Okay, fair enough. I give you that. But like, let's say all of these people who are like really, really religious, or what the fuck?
Then they're probably tuned out by now, to be honest, because they would have been outraged by what I said earlier.
Probably. Yeah. But I'm talking about like all these people who don't have opportunities such as us to like live life to the fullest, live life like it's your last, right? And they have is like religion and surviving till the other day.
Everybody has that opportunity, fam. Everybody has that opportunity.
Fam, you're telling me people who live in rural areas...
I had that argument with him.
My father...
$1 a day.
My father would starve for 3 days and not have food. And he worked his ass off to be in the position where he can send his son to go get an education.
And but that was him, though. He was lucky, I would say.
Because he believed in himself. That's what people need to do. Believe in yourself and live it. He always tells me.
But some people don't get the opportunity.
It's not a matter of presenter with. It's not a matter of opportunity. He had no one, no father, no mother, no nothing. He was the eldest child and he took care of his siblings. Life happens. But
wouldn't you say he was privileged in certain scenarios, though?
Like, privileged how?
Would that scenario open up to anybody else?
You just said now that if you grew up dirt poor, like, you can't achieve anything. And I'm telling you that you can. Because you believe in something and you wait for something is why people are never successful. Because they don't take the leap. You need to take the leap. You need to believe in yourself and do something. That is not discrediting your creator. That is simply taking charge of your life. Don't wait. Don't wait for anything. Go out and do it yourself instead of sitting and waiting for something to drop from heaven. Nothing drops from heaven.
But what if you try and it never happens?
It will happen. That's why people give up too quickly. It will happen. Anybody that's successful now, we interviewed Lindsay. She said there were days when she wanted to give up music, but she kept going. You've heard Bill Gates. There are days he felt like this wasn't going to work. Mark Zuckerberg, Barack Obama.
No, but nobody we're talking about people in, like, villages.
We just talked about a person who was in a village. You don't think my dad felt like killing himself?
But he was that one person who became... Who was because presented with some opportunity that another wasn't because presented with in that same village.
Nobody is not presented with opportunities. Opportunities come. It is left for you to recognize an opportunity that is presented to you and take advantage of it, not to wait. That's why when opportunities come to us or to me, I take advantage of it and I will exploit it. You don't sit around waiting for things to happen. Go out and make them happen for yourselves. And that's the problem I have with religion. It makes people feel content and make them want to wait for things. Don't wait. Go and do it. You want to be the best in the world. Find out, learn, study, go out and do it.
Yeah, I agree with your point of view there too. It's like somewhere in the middle.
But where does religion say you to like wait and be content with yourself though?
No, because...
I think I've spoken quite at length.
You know how when some people, you know, they have that mindset that, God's actually, you know, made me suffer, put me in this position. I've been praying to God, but he's not giving me or she's not giving me anything, no opportunity. So they kind of feel that they've been put in that position where they can't actually leap forward and change their life. So they believe that God actually put them in that situation.
To be honest, all of this, I think, is like, I think you guys are just pissed at people using religion as an excuse to do whatever the fuck. Because religion is the thing that gets exploited the most. People use religion to kill people. People use religion to make money. People use religion as an excuse for what they're not, what they are. But like
I'm not blaming religion. I'm saying religion encourages groupthink.
Has a tendency to do that.
You're more likely to believe what everybody else is believing because you're in that group. So you behave like everybody else in that group.
So then by the end of the day, even though it encourages us...
Especially the older generation.
Of course, yeah, the older generation is done for. But especially if it encourages it, doesn't it come down to the human being himself to like change this thing?
We've been saying. That's what I've been saying. That's what I've been saying. Stop group thinking. Think for yourself. No need to follow another person's philosophy.
But not everyone
philosophy.
Can do that.
Everyone can do that. You can break away from it if you choose to. Life is a choice. We all have that free choice. But people are lazy.
I'm a puppet, man.
Puppet to who? No, if you choose. It's because people are lazy to think for themselves. That's why they're in that situation. Don't be lazy. Go out and learn, but do things.
But dude, like, don't you feel like whatever you do, you've been set down this path, though?
I don't believe. Yeah, this is... And Yash has also said, like, I think, like, you take the... There's always a... It's like a game. You know those games where you can free roam and you have choices? Between what you do? Like, that horror game that came out, was it last year? Till Dawn? Dawn? You know how when you play that game and you choose one path, the ending will be different?
Yeah.
I think that's how life is. So you choose, you'll be presented with, usually it's two opportunities, fight or flight. If you stay in that position, you will stay there. Or if you choose to go in a different position, you know, you go. That's what I think. I don't think if you just do whatever, you will remain in that position.
I don't know, man. To be honest, I think that I'm taking all these decisions, like all these opportunities, whatever like comes about, like, and then I like take them. I never think that I'm fully controlled because like whatever I've been influenced by, whatever I've like been through my life, it's all been setting me down to go this certain direction. So essence, I'm like the byproduct of like things around me. So I'm never like my whole being myself. You know what I'm saying? I'm never fully,
I think you're conditioning yourself to think like that because when you are faced with tough times, you make a decision. You either choose, like for example, what's a good example actually? I didn't even think about a good example before
passing
I started shouting.
Passing your exams.
Good luck, boys. That's when people remember their religion the most.
Well,
true.
Don't they?
It's like, okay, you're making a decision, yet. I don't know what's a good thing. I'm trying to think of something good. Like, for example, going to a different country.
Uh-huh.
Going to a different country, you've made a decision to leave where you're at because you know the opportunities presented to you there uh-huh. are different. So, like, uh-huh. an Asian immigrant to America, you can't tell me if he becomes successful with his business there, he would have had the same path if he had stayed in China.
No, but then again, wasn't he driven by circumstances back in his home country?
And he made there, though? And he made a decision. So you you control it because you make the decision. You can stay within that circumstance. You can be in China and it's like fucked up and you're like, okay, I will just stay here and continue to live it. Or you can say, no, I will not stay here. I'll go and look for a better life. And you leave and you perhaps go to America and you start a business and you become a millionaire. You made a choice.
But the thing is, like, the reason people make these choices is, like, before that, they were influenced by these people who, like, strive to take chances, strive to, like, obviously, okay, the person who doesn't take that decision to go out...
That same asshole has turned on his car. That same fucking asshole. That same asshole has turned on his car.
Oh, fuck, man. It's really picking up, man.
Anyway, what did you say?
Oh, fuck, dude, it's really bad.
No, it's okay, don't worry. What did you say?
But yeah, I'm just saying, like we can delve into, like, the characteristics of both of the people, right? The person that says no to this opportunity and the person that says yes. The person that says no, he's been, like, first of all, do you agree, like, the personality and the character that you come up with is, like, it's basically, like, been influenced by the things that you grew up with. Is that mm-hmm. true or not?
Yes, your environment and genetics, obviously. Yes, I agree with that.
Does change you, right? Okay, so you absorb everything.
Yeah, not anyway, everything, so, but yeah, you absorb
not everything, but most of the things. You're influenced by the things that are around you.
Yes.
So, upon coming to this decision already, you've already been influenced by motherfuckers to either pick this decision or not. Because obviously, if you're going to pick the decision that that lets you go out for better opportunities, which is risky too, by the way,
mm-hmm.
it means, like, you've been influenced by people who, like, strive to get out of their comfort zone, strive to go on for better things, even though it might have really harsh repercussion on your future, opposed to the person that, like,
that's true.
Opts to take the easy way out.
You could chalk it up to the person's personality, because there are outliers where people would be in a place where everybody else just is, like, nonchalant and they choose to be, but they're always outliers. So yes, I would agree with you that in some cases it comes down to the person's courage, but then again, you also have to admit that it is still that person's choice to not want to change their life.
I think the main thing I'm making this argument is because of, like, fate and destiny. I mean, like, surely you don't believe in fate and destiny anymore, do you?
I don't know. I just believe that you should take chances. Don't be scared to take your chances.
No, but real talk, though. Like, do you believe in fate or destiny?
Yes, you do.
No. Do I?
Because, like, the way you've been talking, like, you don't believe in fate or destiny because, like, fate or destiny is, like, from the day you're born, like, you're destined to get this thing. Like no matter what choices, no matter what you take...
I'm sure you can agree with that.
You are going down this path. So by essence, like, you're not controlling yourself if this has all been written for you. Destiny is basically having a script.
Something like saying... follow that script. Yeah, like, everything happens for a reason kind of thing.
Well, let's just say that... I pray that I know that our destiny is to be great. So, yeah, let's just be great, man. Let's just be great.
Dude, let's go, man. This has been like one heavy, intense fucking
session. Yeah, it started off very light and then got really, like, deep.
Dude, it got really dark, man. It got into, like, fucking destiny and what if there's life after death? What the fuck?
Yeah, it got really deep. I'm going to just call this a really deep conversation.
All right, man, let's end this with a bang, man. Fuck.
Okay, bang. Goodbye.
Oh my, I think...
Anyway, man, it's been a pleasure talking to you bitches.
Hopefully you guys stayed for the whole like hour 47 minutes, man. Fuck, that was long, yo.
Yeah, I know what else is long. But anyway, I hope next week you guys will be on time. Fucking dickheads. But yeah.
I was on time, what the fuck?
It's been a pleasure talking to you bitches. My name is Dijaji Prime.
I'm Yesh.
And I'm Tayash.
We hope you enjoyed this little ramble. We still don't know sometimes what we're talking about. And yeah, I haven't done the outro yet. Calm the fuck
I know,
down.
I was just saying.
Shut up. Anyway, we hope you learned something. We hope you enjoyed this, you know, little rambling here. And please be sure to subscribe if you do. And yeah, we'll see you next week. Or yeah, we'll see you next week. My name is Dijaji Prime and we hope you have a blessed day. This is the ITK. Goodbye.
Okay, bye.
Okay.